especially when they're not near what they're saying they are. On to the next story. This fits right in with it. This is Drew Brees. I haven't even watched this video yet, but Drew Brees, you might know him as the very popular, or at least was before this, quarterback for the New Orleans Saints, did some sort of bring your Bible to school thing. So we're going to watch it. I haven't even watched it yet. And then we're going to, you know, get into what the media is saying about it. So this is what Drew Brees posted.
Hey guys, Drew Brees here. One of my favorite verses in the Bible is 2 Corinthians 5:7, "For we live by faith, not by sight." So I want to encourage you to live out your faith on Bring Your Bible to School Day and share God's love with friends. You're not alone.
All right, so seemed pretty harmless. Bring your Bible to school day, and Drew Brees just got absolutely maligned in the media. They said he's anti-LGBT. They said, you know, he's horrible, he's terrible. And we're gonna play his apology video real quick, and then I'm gonna get into some stuff. So that's what he said, and then he's got to apologize.
There's been a lot of negativity spread about me in the LGBTQ community recently, based upon a article that someone wrote with a very negative headline that I think led people to believe that somehow I was aligned with an organization that was anti-LGBTQ and so on and so forth. I'd like to set the record straight. I live by two very simple Christian fundamentals, and that is love the Lord with all your heart, mind, and soul, and love your neighbor as yourself. I think the first one is very self-explanatory. The second one, love your neighbor as yourself. What does that mean to me? That means love all, respect all, and accept all. So that is actually how I live my life. That is what I try to do with my family, with my teammates, with people in my community, with my friends, all people, no matter your race, your color, your religious
preference. It's okay, Drew. Just give the kids the Bible. It's fine, buddy.
Your political beliefs, it doesn't matter.
It's not a big deal,
bro. So the fact that these rumors have been spread about me are completely untrue. What I did was I filmed a video recently that was encouraging kids to bring their Bibles to school for National Bring Your Bible to School Day.
Mm-hmm.
To bring your Bibles to school, to be able to live out your faith with confidence, and I even gave one of my favorite Bible
verses.
Drew's
figuring out what America really is.
So I'm not sure why the negativity spread or why people tried to rope me into certain negativity. I do not support any groups that discriminate or that have their own agendas that are
Drew,
trying
wait,
to,
is that Chick-fil-A in the background?
Inequality.
Is Drew eating anti-LGBTQ
so,
food?
Hopefully that has set the record straight.
Hold on.
And we can all move on.
He looks like his guts filled with disgusting Chick-fil-A. All right. So that's the scoop. Drew Brees just did a very harmless bring your Bible to school thing. And that's what how they treated him. So I wanted to say this because, like I said, I believe in equality. I believe in freedom. I believe in protecting groups when it comes to every race, religion, and gender. I'm looking at medical freedom. I'm looking at the First Amendment. I'm looking at the Second Amendment. I'm looking at protecting good people from all races, religions, and genders. Unlike a lot of analysts, I don't use people as a shield to push my political agenda to say, oh my God, I love these people. And then they pass some anti-free speech legislation. No, anomaly, I love these people more than you. And then you pass anti-Second Amendment legislation. No, look, it's this race, it's this supremacy, that supremacy. Then you pass, you know, the Walmart thing. I don't do that. I'm very fair. And I want to read someone on Twitter, Mike Cernovich said, Drew Brees is learning what America's true religion is. I'll read that again. Drew Brees is learning what America's true religion is. And I answered with this, and I really want people to think about this. And this is not an attack on any country or any person. This is just the reality of what's happening on planet Earth. I said, in Muslim-majority countries, Islam is embraced. That's a fact. Every Muslim-majority country, Islam is not only embraced, most places it's the law of the land. You know, the law of Islam is the law of the land. So if you're Islamic and you're Muslim, if you're in a country that has a majority of Muslims, you're fine to express your faith. That's totally okay. In the only Jewish majority country, I would say, Israel, you know, Judaism celebrated. You don't have to hide your Judaism in the shadows in Israel, nor should you. I mean, it's a Jewish country. It's the Jewish state. You know, they're very proud of it. Why should you have to hide the fact that you're you know, Judaism in Israel? You shouldn't. In a Christian majority, in every Christian majority country, not every, but at least continent, you could talk about Europe maybe, and then United States, especially United States, Christians are persecuted by mass media. Am I missing something? in Muslim majority countries, Islam is embraced. You have all these activists who say they're standing up for gay and lesbians, you know, the most, but in America, LGBT is treated better than, you know, anyone. This is like one of the greatest places to be gay in the United States. What are you complaining about? And like a lot of conservatives always point out, look at the Middle East. That's where they actually don't treat gay people well. So if you're really up in arms, you're getting mad at the people who love you the most. It's going to end up bad for you. It's like you're punching your father. It's like, you know, they're like trying to protect you. And it's like you could march in the streets. You could have a television show. No one cares what you do in America, quite literally. You have to stage some sort of fake Chick-fil-A protest. We'll get into it in a second. But in a Muslim majority country, Islam is embraced and LGBT isn't embraced. In a Jewish majority country, Judaism is embraced. Only in Christian majority countries and in Christian majority continents are their own majority persecuted by the media. I mean, this is very, very, very rare. You don't really see this anywhere. In America, same with, you know, racially. It's like and the reason that I think that it happens, just to be quite frank, is because Christians, for the most part, there's definitely some annoying, obnoxious, terrible Christians. Trust me, there's some really bad, you know, phony Christian leaders, I think a lot of them, to be quite frank. But Christians, I think, on the whole, on average, are pretty nice compared to, you know, if you're in a Muslim majority country, you're not going to be able to persecute Muslims. You're just not. They're not going to accept that. If you're in Israel, I mean, I don't know how tolerant they are, but I'm guessing, you know, they wouldn't want a bunch of media sources just constantly just, you know, treating the majority religion like, you know, like they're outsiders and criminals in their own country. And in the United States, I just, you know, Christians are, it's very obvious, just can't even say bring your Bible to school. They want to trace everything to every group is this, they're anti-LGBT. Some Christians are anti-LGBT. Most Muslims are anti-LGBT. Not every Christian organization. It is what it is. I mean, I don't know. When it comes to Chick-fil-A, we'll get into it in a second too. If you can make better chicken and make a better, you know, fast food service, you should do that on atheism or some sort of other, you know, principles that you want to make it under, or non-religious principles. Make it. Why is Chick-fil-A the most friendly? Why are they the friendliest of all the fast foods? Why are they usually the cleanest of all fast foods as far as when you go in? I don't know. Maybe it's because they're Christian, you know? Maybe they have Christian values and they actually... It's the same with, like, this demonization of, like, certain people. I'll tell you, you know, if you live in Los Angeles, Glendale is very safe. Glendale is very nice. It's very clean. Why is Glendale clean, nice, and safe? Probably because most of the people who live there are Armenians, and Armenians take care of things. I don't know. They have pride in their own city. It's not like their city officially, but anybody who's from LA pretty much knows, you know, Armenians are all over Glendale, and they keep it clean. They keep it safe. They keep it nice. I don't care if they're Christian. I don't care if they're Muslim. I don't care if they're atheist. They actually clean their cities. Chick-fil-A actually sells, you know, decent fast food, and it's clean and they're friendly. Why is Salt Lake City is you know, a pretty nice, clean city? I mean, it's like Mormons take care of their shit. I don't, you know, it is what it is. So it's like this constant, everyone's like, we want everyone here. That's fine, but then clean the streets. If you can't keep it clean, then at least shut your mouth about other people. Mind your own business. If you can make a clean, safe, secure, you know, functioning society that's greater than everyone else, then you can start talking crap about Chick-fil-A. But if you can't make better chicken, you can't talk crap about it. If you can't, you know, if your state has the highest poverty, one of the highest taxes, and working people are getting screwed left and right, teachers are on strike, you know, pollution is probably worse than in most places in the United States, not in Asia. And weirdly enough, they never talk about that. I had lunch with somebody from Asia today, and they were telling me how great the sky is. And I'm very actually grateful to be in LA now, because I looked at the sky and I was like, you think it's clean out here? And she was like, in Asia, you can't even see the sky. Like in China, you can't even see, like, you're dying. They're just killing you. It's like, you can't even go outside. There's like, you know, smog everywhere. And in a lot of parts of Japan and Thailand, and even there, she said it's way worse. She said, this is clean. I was like, that's perspective. You know, that's why it's good to be, you know, well-traveled, or at least, you know, open-minded to other cultures. Cause then I'm like, wow, LA is clean. She's like, this is the cleanest air I've ever, you know, as far as like where she's from. Interesting. But you know, with the whole Christian thing, it's like Christians are starting to get tired of being persecuted. He could say, I mean, if he was doing give your the Quran to school day. I don't know that some media would treat him like that. Although I would say conservative media probably would treat him terrible. But but anyway, I don't want to get into all that right now. I really don't want to get into religion too much, although we have to for this. But Drew Brees is finding out, like Cerno said, he's finding out what America is. It's not really a Christian nation. I mean, there's definitely a majority of Christian people, but only in this country are they treated terribly. And to the mass media, I want to say, just have a conversation, be respectful, talk to some Christians. And it's like, it's okay to like God. It's okay to like the Bible. It's okay to not, but have a little bit of respect for Drew Brees and see what he's about before you slander him. On the next one, someone say, that's why you see Asians wearing masks sometimes. Yeah, it's terrible. In Beijing, it's horrible. I think air pollution kills a couple million people a year, and it's like miserable. A lot of them are depressed. Imagine going outside and you can't even see above the building because there's so much smog. She said it's like being in a garage with like 10 people with their motorcycles revving in a closed garage. It's an exaggeration, but it's really, really bad. I mean, even pollution in America, we're actually one of the better ones in the world. We're constantly improving when it comes to a lot of carbon emissions or whatever, but a lot of these Asian countries, they suck at it. But on the side note too, it's like Japan keeps their streets very clean. I think there's something to be learned from Japan. They keep their streets incredibly clean. Why? Because they want to. And then that's the rule. And if you don't follow it, you get in trouble. That's what I'm saying. Even with the Epstein, all this, people need to get held accountable. You should be able to be free and have fun. I don't care what you do personally. I don't care what you do in the bedroom. I don't care who you like, who you dislike, who you have preference towards. That doesn't bother me. But it's like, can't we make America great again by having pride? It's like, what if everybody, it was like really taboo to trash the streets instead of it being like status quo in some of these cities? In certain places, it is like that, and it's way better to live. Everyone's happier, It's a great community to live in, one that's not trashy, so let's do it. Someone said Bangkok is very polluted. Yeah, most of Asia is, because they just crank out factories, and, it's tough to breathe. Next story I want to talk about was Chick-fil-A. They're staging some sort of a die-in. I'm going to watch it real quick. So it's a confused die-in because some people are there for animal rights, and at least that, I mean, there's other places besides Chick-fil-A, killing animals, but it's more of like an LGBT protest. They're saying, Chick-fil-A, is killing gays or something. I don't know exactly what point they're really trying to make, except I guess Chick-fil-A is Christian. They might not support the LGBT agenda. That's their right, I guess. It's like, half the media says like, hates straight people. They're just like, you can't say this, you didn't do that. I don't know. It's just like, they're allowed to have their critiques of, someone's sexuality. I don't see anything wrong with that. People can critique straightness if you want, it's like, they force this stuff and they're like, you have to agree with it. It's like, I'm at the point now where I'm like, I don't have to agree. Like, I don't care what you do personally, but if somebody's Christian and they don't agree, I personally think they have the right to do that. If someone's Muslim and they don't agree, they have the right to do that. I don't see the big problem. If they're acting on it or hurting people in this country, it doesn't fly. But they're staging a die-in, and I said something. I'm going to say it. I thought it was pretty funny, but I'm sure this will be hate speech now too, but I don't care. I'm having more fun now. I'm just trying to enjoy the madness. I said, I'm sure raw anal sex and laying on the streets of a liberal city will cause more disease and suffering to the LGBT community than Chick-fil-A will, but that's none of my business. And people thought that was pretty funny. And I don't say that to demonize people. I'm just saying, personally, I think it's okay to have a conversation. Like, regardless if you're straight or gay, there does seem to be a disease problem. And maybe it's because we're not supposed to be having sex so much. And maybe we're not supposed to be having sex with butts. If you do, trust me, I'm not God. I'm not like super religious in the sense of like I demonize everybody who has sex out of marriage. That's not me. Trust me, I've had fun in my life. But however, it's okay to question that. Like if somebody comes along and they're like, I'm Christian, and I'm really, maybe you shouldn't have sex out of wedlock. I'm not going to demonize them and say, oh my God, they're killing me. I'm going to be like, why do you think that? And then they might actually convince me. It's like there's a lot of Christians who think porn is damaging. I know a lot of people don't want to hear that, but as somebody who has, seen porn, They did a study on Twitter and they said, when were you exposed to porn? And a majority of people said between like 8 and 12 or 8 and 14. Should little kids be, you know, exposed to porn at 8 and 14? I don't think so, but most are. So maybe that is a problem. I'm not, you could say free speech, there should be porn, it should be free, it should be all online. You have the right to say that. As of now, they have the right to do it. You know, that's fine, but if you want to have a counter conversation, like maybe porn's bad, that's fine. It doesn't mean you can't do it if you want to. You can be gay, but not everyone has to like it. And also, I do want to say, it's like having sex with a woman's vagina, there's risks that come along with it. You know, there's, you could get like, you could get someone pregnant. You know, you could get an STD. And if you have sex with someone's butthole, just to be very non-PC right now, you know, your skin-to-skin contact, if it's unprotected, and blood, and, you know, it's like, it's might not be the most sanitary thing. I don't know. I'm not here to tell you not to do it. Like I said, I've had fun in my life. I'm not a pastor by any means, but it's okay to question if it's right or wrong. It's okay to be like, maybe I shouldn't do that. You know, it's like, maybe our culture is bred to believe it's cool to just go out and do all this stuff, but maybe it's not cool. You know, maybe it's not cool for straight people. Maybe it's not cool for gay people. Maybe, you know, maybe it is. I'm not here to tell you what is and what's not cool, but you know, there is risks there. And it's like you push back a little bit. They're like, oh my God, you don't agree with it. It's like, you don't have to. And the more weird stuff they do, the more I do disagree with it. You can love who you love and do what you want to do, but like the fact that it's gone from, can I marry who I want to marry? I never really cared about that because I always thought about it in a funny way. I was like, they're just going to have to pay, give half their house away and half their, you know, child support or whatever. It's like, they're going to have to suffer just like married families do when they divorce. It's not a big deal to me. It's like a government sanctioned thing. Now you owe half the house to Jeremy. Damn it. I knew I shouldn't have got gay married. So I never cared about gay marriage. I was actually pro gay marriage. And now, you know, I still don't care. Honestly, I'm not like a politician or I don't even know what marriage paperwork looks like, so I don't even care. But overall, now the LGBT agenda has become so much more than being gay. It has nothing to even do with being gay now. It's like LGBTQSTLV, like, you know, drag queens twerking in front of kids at libraries. It's like, I don't agree with that. Even with straight people, if there's a woman twerking at a library, I would be like, probably not a good idea. You know, somebody who supports me, who I met recently, came out, you know, her son is listening to one rap song. I feel bad about that. I was like, that's not, you know, I curse in that song. That one was kind of for adults. I even feel bad about that, let alone, you know, twerking in front of 10-year-olds. It's like, that, what does that have to do with LGBT? So Chick-fil-A doesn't have to like you. You know, Chick-fil-A doesn't have to support your sexuality. Chick-fil-A can't demonize you or persecute you, and they don't. They can't hurt you in any way, but, you know, they don't have to agree with it. And I guess the media doesn't have to agree with Drew Brees and the Bible either, but my thing is, like, every other majority country, only in a Christian majority country are Christians persecuted. That's just how it works. And, you know, as far as media persecution, and I don't know, the more weird stuff that goes on like this in Hong Kong, they're fighting for their freedom. You know, in Nigeria, people are murdering each other. Like, people don't realize how great America is, even pollution-wise. I think pollution's bad in LA. You know, somebody tells me that, like, I have it great, because Asian pollution's way worse. Makes you very grateful. And the climate's great. But, you know, it's the same with, like, LGBT. You think it's bad here for LGBT? You know, take a trip to Palestine with Charlie Kirk. He's over there trying to make it gayer. You could see that they don't like it there. You know, go to Saudi Arabia. Like they say, this is not the worst place to be gay. It might be the best place to be gay. It's not the worst place to be a woman. Might be the best place to be a woman. And it's not I don't know all these like weirdo protests. I just think, you know, if people don't appreciate and don't target their activism, right, they're just going to keep screwing things up. So it's like for the LGBT stuff, I'm sure the modern day, like the die-in probably made more people hate gay people than yesterday. It's like now there's probably 500,000 people who are less. I don't know. So overall, someone said that, you get it. Overall, that's the story. I mean, the Chick-fil-A stage in, it's just, I get where they're coming from, but it's so crazy. And also, I wanted to say too, before I move on, in South Africa right now, they're having huge problems. In America, Trump, they say Trump has this xenophobic language against, you know, minorities and all this stuff, and he says build a wall. A lot of conservatives don't agree with mass illegal migration. That's just true. It's illegal. They don't have to agree with it. But in America, most people, it's a pretty, I mean, there is crime and stuff, but people don't really act on it. They just, you know, express their things and vote at the ballot box. Like, there's not a lot of crime in that direction. In South Africa, it's really bad. The whole country is basically destabilized because a lot of South Africans are murdering other Africans. You know, there's these problems that are in America. A lot of them are all over the world. Like, if you want to talk about xenophobia in America, this is one of the least xenophobic places in the world. Perhaps maybe the least xenophobic place in the world. Maybe Canada or Europe could give it a run for its money. There's no better place for foreigners than America. In South Africa, they're getting literally murdered for being, they're black, but the people in South Africa that are also black, they don't look at them through the lens of the liberal in America, like, oh, they're all the same to me, they're all just minorities. They hate them for coming to their country. Even though in America, you just call them African Americans and group them all in together, they don't group themselves in together in South Africa. They have their own xenophobic struggles with outside their nation. And same with like the Mexican world, the Hispanic world, the South American, Central American world. They don't look at each other like they're your little, you know, toys to get people to vote for. Mexicans, South Americans, you know, from each, they have their own little beefs and qualms. Trust me, there's a lot of hostility in the Hispanic world, I would say more so than in America. People in America don't really care. You know, if you have Hispanic friends or you have family from there, you know, it's beautiful, it's great. I'm not saying there's a lot of amazing people, but there is competition between countries and there is disdain for, you know, other people. So it's not specifically a white or American thing. It's all over the world, all of our problems. I mean, crime here is probably worse than it is in Asia in many places. However, you know, I heard it's better to be a woman here than it is to be in Asia. You get more freedom as a woman here. So, and then also crime in, you know, Africa and certain parts of, you know, other countries is much, much worse. I mean, you know, there's a lot of islands as well with a lot of problems. So I'm just saying, put this stuff in perspective, because when these activists just cry about Chick-fil-A, it shows how privileged and spoiled rotten you are. It's like Chick-fil-A really doesn't care, and 95% of the media and 95% of the activist organizations are in your favor. It's not like 99% of the country is Christian, conservative, breathing down your neck, trying to like kill you. That's not what's happening in America. You can march in the streets and twerk in front of 10-year-olds, which is disgusting, and legitimately they let you do that. It's not a bad place to be. Please you know, be grateful of America. Don't use your sexuality to take away guns, to take away the First Amendment, to take away, you know, medical freedom. Now they're doing that in California. I did a whole stream on it yesterday. They're hiding, you know, anti-medical freedom and medical tyranny behind this guise of like liberalism and we're gonna save the kids. It's so twisted. Final story I wanna talk about.